Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Manila Cathedral. Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata. God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me and sent me to preach good news to the poor, to heal the brokenhearted, and to let the oppressed go free. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you give us new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made your only begotten Son eternal High Priest, grant that those he has chosen as ministers and stewards of your mysteries may be found faithful in carrying out the ministry they have received. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, it is widely reported that there is immorality among you, and immorality of a kind not found even among pagans, a man living with his father's wife. And you are inflated with pride. Should you not rather have been sorrowful? The one who did this deed should be expelled from your midst. I, for my part, although absent in body, but present in spirit, have already, as if present, pronounced judgment on the one who has committed this deed, in the name of our Lord Jesus. When you have gathered together, and I am with you in spirit, with the power of the Lord Jesus, you are to deliver this man to Satan for the destruction of his flesh, so that his spirit may be saved on the day of the Lord. Your boasting is not appropriate. Do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? clear out the old yeast, so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight. You hate all evildoers.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful the Lord abhors.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
But let all who take refuge in you be glad and exult forever. Protect them that you may be the joy of those who love your name.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Kami ay gawin mong daan ng iyong pag-ibig kapayapaan at katarungan. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On a certain Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and taught. And there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees watched him closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. But he realized their intentions and said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up and stand before us." And he rose and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than destroy it?" Looking around at them all, he then said to them, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, in our first reading today, St. Paul reprimands the community in Corinth because of an immorality being done among the Christians. A man living with his father's wife, probably his stepmother. And St. Paul said, this kind of immorality is even unacceptable among the pagans, and yet you are allowing it to happen in your community as Christians. St. Paul was so disgusted and disappointed at the laxity of their morality. Mga Kristiyano kayo, parang sinasabi ni San Pablo.
Pero bakit hinahayaan ninyong mangyari ang ganitong imoralidad sa inyong komunidad? At hindi lang hinahayaan, parang ipinagmamalaki pa ninyo ang mga bagay na ito. And so, St. Paul talks of expelling that person who committed immoral acts from the community in order that there may not be more harm in the community. But it must be clear, my dear brothers and sisters, that the intention of St. Paul to exclude that person doing immoral acts is not just to get rid of him. The intention of St. Paul was that exclusion might bring him back to his senses, and this might help him return to the community and so save his soul. St. Paul pointed out what is wrong in order to correct and to restore. In our gospel today, Jesus healed a man with a withered hand. Jesus also saw something wrong in the man. His hand is withered. He saw a defect in the person, and so he restored the man. He healed him. He made him whole again. For that is the mission of Jesus. The mission of Jesus is not just to pinpoint what is wrong in a person or in society. The mission of Jesus is not just to find faults and sin happening. The mission of Jesus is to restore, to heal, to forgive, and to save. But the scribes and the Pharisees were not happy at what Jesus did, because Jesus healed on a Sabbath. And take note, my dear brothers and sisters, that they were watching Jesus closely so that they may have something to accuse him of. The scribes and the Pharisees were trying to find fault in Jesus in order to condemn him, in order to get rid of him, in order to destroy him. My dear brothers and sisters, let us not be like the scribes and the Pharisees who have the hobby of finding faults in order to accuse others. Let us not be like the scribes and the Pharisees who are enjoying seeing faults in others, seeing mistakes in others, who enjoy pointing out the sins of others in order to condemn them. Madalas, katulad tayo ng mga eskriba at mga pariseyo na ang tatalas ng mga mata pagdating sa paghahanap ng mali sa kapwa at sa lipunan. Kapag dating sa mga mali, mga kasalanan ng iba, sa mga hindi tamang ginagawa ng iba, ang bilis-bilis nating magsalita, ang bilis-bilis nating pumuna. Pero hanggang doon na lang sa pagpuna at sa pagsasalita. Whenever we find fault in another person, or whenever we see mistakes and even sins, let us not just criticize. Let us offer help in order to correct the situation, to restore the person, to remedy what is wrong, to heal, and even to forgive. Huwag lamang magaling pumuna, sana pagkatapos ng pagpuna, sabihin natin, handa akong tumulong para maayos natin ito. Huwag lamang mag-criticize, ialay din ang ating sarili para sa ikabubuti ng ating kapwa. Let us not just criticize, let us also do our part in improving the person or the situation. My dear brothers and sisters, may all of us be like Saint Paul and Jesus. When we see mistakes, errors, and even sin, let us not just criticize, let us not just pinpoint what is wrong, but let us do our very best in order to correct, to restore, to heal, to remedy, to forgive, and to save. And let us see to it that we do this with love and out of love. For us Christians, there is no higher law than the gospel command of loving God and neighbor. Let us affirm this belief as we pray for the needs of each member of the church as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may always be renewed and purified by the words of Christ's gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in authority may be guided by wisdom when making decisions and setting priorities, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our worship may reflect our sincerity and dedication to the humble service of God and neighbor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may bring hope to the despairing and comfort to the sick, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may now rest in the company of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our personal petitions. We pray for those who requested our prayers, and we also include in our prayers the intentions offered in this Mass. Heavenly Father, you search our hearts and you know our innermost thoughts. Inspire our hearts for more sincere worship and our hands for more willing service to others. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that their labors may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in your goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Broderick our Administrator and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now pray to the Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for God, the living God.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We thank you for joining us in our Mass this morning, and thank you also for all the donation and help that you have been sending us. Tomorrow, September 8, we will celebrate the Feast of the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and our Masses will still be live streamed in our Facebook page and in our YouTube channel. Tomorrow, because it is the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Manila Cathedral will be opened for those of you who wish to come and offer prayers to Our Lady. The Manila Cathedral will be open from 8 o'clock until 11:30 in the morning, and from 1 o'clock in the afternoon until 5 o'clock in the afternoon. We will, of course, observe all the proper safety protocols. And tomorrow evening at 9 o'clock, we shall have our weekly healing rosary for the world. Dahil po birthday ni Mama Mary, instead of doing it on Wednesday, we shall have it tomorrow evening. And our healing rosary will be led by our Archbishop Emeritus, Cardinal Gaudencio Rosales. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagpalang nilikha, ipinagliing walang sala, song dalis ay dakila. Maria, ina ng awa.
Sacrifice, live and let him go. Share the treasure I know that is God within my soul.
Poor and humble heart, offering pain and strife.
Lord, to you I give all, my everything, my love and sacrifice. In the face of the aged, I see your wisdom.
In the face of the sick, I see your wounds.
In the face of the poor, I see your loving home.
In all of is Lord, I give my all. Love and sacrifice, live and letting go, share the treasure I know, that is God within my soul. Poor and humble heart, offering pain and strife, for to you I give all, my everything, my love and sacrifice.
In the face of trials, I see your saving cross.
In the face of danger, I see your hand.
In the face of prayer, I see your heart.
In the face of love, I see but you.
Love and sacrifice, live and letting go, share the treasure I know, that is God within my soul. Poor and humble heart, offering pain and strife, Lord, to you I give all, my everything, my love and sacrifice.
Love and sacrifice, live and letting go, share the treasure I know, that is God within my soul.
Lord.